Hi, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. Joining me now is Scott Berdahl, the CEO of Snowline Gold. And Scott, good to have you back again. How are you?
Great, Steve. Thanks for having me here.
So reporting some results from your Einarson project. I know you're still waiting for a lot more results to come back, obviously with slow lab times like everyone else, but you did get some a few back, and these ones, as you've had in the past, continue to show really positive results.
Yeah, so the headline number here is 13.9 grams over 6 meters, but that really doesn't tell the whole story. What we've done is we've drilled a big fan out from around our discovery hole that we reported back in August. Those were rushed results. Now we have, you know, the surrounding holes and the sort of real-time results. And you have that interval of the 13.9 grams. But if you look at figure one in today's release, you can see that we really fanned out and covered a large area and hit in each hole multiple very nice zones of gold mineralization. You have in that same hole, you have 5 grams over 5 meters and 13 grams over, 13 meters of 3 grams and so on down the hole, 9.5 meters of 5 grams, 6 meters of 10 grams. And, you know, you just keep hitting these zones. So what we're showing or what we're seeing is that we're into what looks to be a big mineralized system. And so we're obviously very excited.
So the holes that you're waiting for, is that continue that sort of fanning as you talked about, or does it move to sort of new areas around what you've already seen?
It moves it steps out farther. So so this was literally a fan from one hole or from one pad site drilled in multiple directions that we're reporting today. Okay. And the subsequent holes that we're waiting for step out, 150 and then 200 meters to the north. And then we have a very big step out, or really a test of a new target that, and we don't know what the continuity is like between them, but that's 1.1 kilometers away. And that's, of course, where we saw visible gold and drill core. So we're very excited to see all of these assays come in.
I would imagine this is sort of giving you some more insight into what Einarson is all about. You've obviously had high hopes for it from the beginning, but these kind of results already are giving you some really good insight into the project, I think.
Absolutely. And so, and that's another thing to remember is that Einarson is a district scale target. And we came into this area thinking that there's an unrecognized gold district here. And so we're on target one of about 10. And these are the results that we're getting. So we're really excited not only to get back out to Jupiter, but to look at the rest of Einarson in a lot more detail next year as well.
Now, you also talked in the news release a bit about Rogue, which is your other project that you have high hopes for as well. You're waiting for quite a few back on Rogue also?
We are. We drilled four holes there, and each one of them had visible gold in the drill core, including the first hole had, it was sheeted veining with visible gold, trace amounts of visible gold, pretty much the whole length of the 161-meter hole. 31 little quartz veins had visible gold in them, and so we're very keen to see those assays and just to see how that sheeted vein system holds together.
All right. Well, congratulations on Einarson so far. We look forward to getting more results back there, and also interested to see what happens at Rogue as well. So, Scott, good to see you again. Thanks very much.
All right. Thanks, Steve. Take care.
All right, there's Scott Berdahl, the CEO of Snowline Gold.